Is it that velocity of wind?
Okay. In any kind of, where do you use this? In farming?
In it has got application in every field. As you can see now, that right now we have mounted one NACA 0012 airfoil. Mm-hmm. Apart from this, you can mount these building blocks. That to simulate any building, that is such a building.
Now, how does it help the farmers or common people?
I'm telling you. Then this, see, what do we make a farm? In an open field, and near about that field, there will be some small huts. Mm-hmm. So what we can do here is that we will make a small wooden model.
Okay.
We'll leave some space blank, and on the side of these blocks, so we can place some small blocks simulating the condition of the actual farm in a very, very reduced manner. Rotation of the fan, then it shows the air velocity. So what we will do here is that they will give us the model, we'll mount the model here, and we will simulate the entire flow characteristic, then we'll study it and we'll send the result to them.
Okay.
Then they can take further management decision per their.
It helps like common men like us also.
It helps,
right?
In every sphere.
It can because save disaster.
Of course.
Your students are learning this?
So you're
learning?
Yeah.
What did
yes,
you learn?
Yeah, this is a aeroplane.
In aeroplane, it helps to lift up. Means this mechanism, the lifting process of aeroplane, it takes place because of this thing.
Who else are learning? You also learning?
Yes, I'm a little bit.
It's good to see a beautiful girl learning. You know, it's amazing. Tell me, what you learned?
Actually, basically, it studies the characteristics of the airflow when air is passed over that object or a body.
Perfect definition. And can you please?
This is about the wind tunnel, and it describes how the air passes through the tunnel and everything about the air.
When you take up this as a profession, can you handle this?
Yes, ma'am, obviously.
Yeah. So much of confidence you have. Nice meeting you girls. This is girl power, and I'm so happy. Thank you for this educating us. Thank you. So, would you like to introduce yourself and also explain what so many machines here we want to know?
I am Professor Arnav Sharma. I am head of the Department of Civil Engineering. And we are now standing at Civil Engineering Department lab, which is Transportation Engineering. We also have here Soil Mechanics lab, and we also have here Concrete Technology lab. We have three labs combined together here. And you can see the machines we normally use for practicals for undergraduate students. However, we can also undertake works only for your master degree students, and also we can undertake a bit of a research work within in this lab.
You said soil mechanics, what's that?
Soil mechanics, probably technically it would be able to, it is something about talking about the...
You test the soil?
We do, that comes to the acidity, that is the chemical property. We here normally deal with the mechanical properties of soil.
Okay.
In terms of its size, in terms of the pressure it can take when a building is constructed. So when it comes to your question like quality, then we go for the environmental engineering lab.
Okay, then there's so much of skyscrapers, buildings coming up. Before that, you need to test the soil, fluidity of the soil. That's it?
Yeah.
Soil mechanics?
Yes, that is part of it. We have more to it, but then when you design a building, when you design for any load, and the building is it rests on the earth. So the soil beneath the building, beneath the structure, has to bear the weight of the machine, the building. And that is why this lab is of importance before you set to design any structure on the earth.
Now, what are the